give the cars I ride in front of a little wave. Excuse me. Thank you. Not that they really move, but... You know, you can't complain because there are people on the Strand at sunset. Tomorrow's Father's Day. I don't know if that makes for an extra busy weekend or not. They got their fans. Folks were singing along. Or it's a famous song. You know, I'll give the tin fish credit when most other things are closed. They're often open. So we went from no clouds at all to marine layer. So far, so good. My lungs are not complaining too bad, neither are my legs. As I get older, I can still pretty much do whatever ride I set out to do, but sometimes it takes longer to recover than it used to. I was a youthful 56 when I moved out here, no, 57. But now that I'm a grizzled old man of 62. Is that a coyote? I believe it is. I don't know. It might be a dog. I can't tell. The jury is out. He said coyote or dog. Either way, I was going to let it be. That must suck to get bit by a coyote. I'm sure it's rare. They really, they're quite skitterish. But, you know, you get bit by a dog, they have to see if the dog has its rabies shots. You get bit by a coyote. I had a friend named Cody. I think you just assume it's rabid. I really don't know. Let's not find out. I've had a few comments from people wishing I would talk more, so be careful what you wish for. Especially given 11 days off, I could be chatty. Put 1,042 miles on the bike since I bought it. I think that was back in early May. Maybe early April. But either way, not bad for 2 or 3 months. I really am able to do much longer rides. Especially with this new bike, it seems to get about 20% better mileage out of the batteries than the old bike. The old bike, I had to replace the back motor twice while it was under warranty. Overheat and melt the connections, mostly when I was going up big hills, so hopefully they fix that. I'm sure I was not the only one. I bet the $1,800 bicycle gets a lot less profitable when you have to replace the motor a couple of times. Flowers are mostly gone. Although there's something down in the riverbed with big yellow flowers. Boy, I went through a bug swarm there. You can feel them hit your forehead. They do not light the bike path after dark. They also do not light this skate park up here. So, sort of self-regulating in terms of when people are going to be out on it. Some kind of water treatment plant thing up here on the right, a lot more noticeable after dark with all the lights on. About a year ago, they tore up almost every street around us, put in a big pipe that I think has to do with recycling the water that we use. I don't know if this water plant has anything to do with that or not. And they paint this wall anytime graffiti appears. Usually the next time I come, it's gone. I have a theory that it has something to do with Camp Pendleton. People painting some kind of messages or something, I don't know what. But they're getting chilly. So we're going to end up at just under 15 miles, but that's fine. Got to ease back into it. Thank you. 35-mile ride planned out in Irvine for next week. Take advantage of the summer solstice coming up here in a week or so. It'll be getting dark about 8:15, maybe a little smidge later. So I can catch the 3:30 Metrolink, get up to Irvine around 4:30, and have a good 3 hours to do my ride.